This program is called a terminal. A terminal is a program where the commands can be typed in and the results can be displayed. This is called a prompt. This is called a cursor. The white stuff here is called a cursor. When you start to type, your command will be typed into this place. The black thing here, you can call it the command line. You can type your command after the command prompt. Remember that whenever you type in a command, you have to type enter to let the operating system know that you would like to execute this command. I've seen people, after finishing a long command, just wait here. Nothing will happen if you do not type enter. So the first command we're going to learn is ls. ls means list. So it will list the contents in the current directory. In a Windows PC, you open a browser, you're going to see what's inside. You can see these are the files, these are the folders. The reason you know that is because they have different icons. This tells you which one is which. However, if you go back to here, how can you tell whether this is a folder, or this is a folder, or this is a file? You cannot tell. We are going to use something called an option, or sometimes we call it a switch of a command. So we're still going to use the ls command. However, we're going to turn on an option called f, or file type. Make sure that there is a space between the command and the command switch or the command options. So if I connect these two together, this would be regarded as a single command. But of course, there's no such a command. So you're gonna have an error message saying that command not found. So make sure that there will be a space in between ls and dash f. And also, please don't add any space between the dash and f. The dash has to be immediately followed by F. Those are some common mistakes when you just get started. Now let's run this one. You can see that now at the end of each file name, you have some symbols. For this one, it is exactly the same as before. Nothing is attached to the end of it. So this would be a normal file, a regular file. It is just a file. For this one, we have a slash attached to it. This tells us that this is a folder. Some of them have this at sign at the end of it. This means that there are shortcuts. In your Windows PC, you can establish a shortcut in your desktop so that you can click and directly go to a folder. This is the same, but in Linux, we call it links. They are linked to something else. This is how we tell the difference between different types of things. We do not rely on icon, we rely on the special characters at the end of the file name using the minus f option. I don't have an example here, but there are more symbols. For example, if you have a star sign there, that means that one is an executable or a program that you can run. This is nice, however, this approach has a drawback. Sometimes people would regard this as part of the file name. So that would be wrong because this app is not part of the file name. If you want to do something with my documents, that's fine. But if you want to do something with my documents app, then you're going to have an error message complaining that there's no such file called my documents app. A better way would be to use color instead of the signs to tell you which one is which. For example, a normal file would be just black, and folder can be blue, and link can be purple, and executable can be red. This way you can tell which one is which from the color instead of from this strange sign at the end of it. To turn on the color for the output of ls, you do ls space and two dashes and then color. Those colors are actually random. You can pick up any color that you like. Later on, we're gonna learn how to set up those colors. You can see, the output of my ls has colors. The blue ones are directories, and the purple ones are links. The orange ones are executables. It is also possible for you to turn off the color. I've met some guy who just prefer black and white. In this case, you're gonna use never. So this is also a very standard syntax for a Linux command. If you have one dash, normally you just give a one letter option. For example, we just learned big F. And if you have two dashes, normally it will followed by a long option. In this case, it's called color, but you can have some other options. For the options, sometimes it can have a argument. In this case, we have a never. And then the argument is given using this equal sign. So let's try this one. Now you can see the difference between the first LS and the second LS. So you turn off the color. Here, I'll emphasize a few things. First of all, Linux commands are case sensitive, meaning that you cannot randomly choose a case. You cannot do like LS minus F. It is different than big F. I cannot type big LS. Terminal complains that this thing cannot be found. But LS would work. Big L, small s doesn't work. Small L, big S doesn't work. You will have to type exactly what I type here. In Windows, it doesn't matter. You can type biggest case, small case. They're going to be regarded as the same thing. But in Linux, it is not. Many people make mistakes here and cannot find out why. So now we learned two options for LS to help us to understand the file type. If you want to know more about the file type, you use another command called file. File, and let's say listen. It says that listen, it's some language script, and it's an ASCII text file, and it's executable. We're going to learn more about a file type just using this command called file. So now you know there are three ways for you to learn about a file type. LS minus big F, LS turn on color, and then the file command. In a Windows machine, you can have this long list. You can actually change your view. You can have small icons and extra large icons, and you have the detailed view. Once you turn on the detailed view, what you're going to have is that you're going to have much more information about the file. For example, the file type and the size of it, and when it is the last modified. Sometimes those information are very important. How can you see those extra information in a Linux terminal? You're going to type a command called ls-l. L means long. This is how I remember it. So there are many information about it. So let's start from the most obvious one. And this is called the last modified time of this file. So that's the same as Windows. And this is the file size. I'll come back to this later. There is something new here that you cannot see in a Windows machine. Let's start with these two first. This is actually the owner of this file. It is me. I own this file. And the second one is called the group. What is a group? As a user, I can belong to some groups. This is my own machine, so I have my own group and I have my own username. But if you go to a Linux server, you can have your own username, and many of you can belong to a single group. The first column looks very strange and it's very long. The first one here, some of them just have a dash, some of them have an L there. If it is only a dash, it is a regular file. If it's L, it means a link. This is just a link to something else. This file started with B. B means directory. This is basically all you need to remember. Nothing that's a regular file. B is a directory, L is a link. After that, we have nine letters there. They are grouped in three groups. R means readable, W means writable, and X means executable. The first three letters are for the owner of this file. It means that I can read, I can write, and I can execute this file. And the second one is for the group. My group members can only read and execute it, but cannot change it. The last one is called others, other users who do not belong to my group. I still allow them to read and execute. A mailbox is very private. I don't want other people to read it. That's why for mailbox, I have full control, but my group member cannot see it, cannot execute it, cannot change it. Other users cannot do anything as well. One thing I need to emphasize is that why a folder or directory is executable, it simply means that you can open it. That's the execution of a folder. You can open it. All the folder has to be executable. If it is not executable, then you cannot open it. You can see it, you can see the existence of it, but you cannot open it. The plus sign means that there is some actual setup of the permissions of this file. And it's complicated. We don't have to cover it today. So we talk about the size of the file. What is the size of this file? It's hard to tell, right? Because this is simply just a long number. A better way to show this is to show it in human readable format. To turn on that, you need the option called edge, which means human readable. Normally, this option always go together with the L option, because only when you use this long list, you're going to see the file size, right? Okay, let's try this one. So this is fine. You can also type this way. Both would work. Minus L space minus H, or simply just minus L H. Now you can see it's 36 megabytes. So if there's nothing, this is just byte, 600 bytes. And this is a 13 kilobyte. This is called a human readable file size. In your Windows machine, and you're gonna see some directories or files hidden there. Normally you will not be able to see it, but if you turn this option on, you can see it. So there is a way to do that in Linux as well. To do that, you need another option of LS. It's called dash A. A means all, to show all. So if you try this one, you can see a lot. If I just use LS, this is much less. If you just take a close look, you're going to see that all the hidden files start with a dot. You can turn a file to a hidden file by putting a dot in front of its file name. It works for both directories and a normal file. But there are two strange things at the very beginning. So there is one dot here and two dots here. To learn what are they, we need to use a option we already learned before. That is F. You see there is a dash behind it. That means that they are directories. Single dot means the current directory, and double dot means the parent directory.